A chronology of Katy Perry's terrible return, while Spanish authorities look into her most recent music video as Katy Perry resumes her singing career, she cannot manage to stay out of trouble. Following the failure of her last two albums to find widespread appeal, Perry's new album, 143, was expected to bring her back to the top of the pop charts, yet so far, Perry's efforts have been ridiculed and criticized by both fans and reviewers. The head of reputation management consultants and PR specialist Eric Schiffer told Business Insider last week that Perry is experiencing a career crisis as a result of the unfavorable publicity she has been receiving. This is a chronology of Perry's awful return. Perry released the cover art and a brief audio clip for Woman's World, the first single from her next album, as a tease on June 17. On social media, fans made fun of the song's lyrics, claiming AI was the author and that they sounded out of date. Some others took issue with the cover image, saying Perry was trying too hard to appeal to Generation Z by copying the look of popular artists like Charlie XCX. Fans quickly learned that Woman's World, which Perry had teased, was co-produced and co-wrote by the infamous producer Dr. Luke. Perry has not collaborated with him since 2013, prior to her downturn in her career. Dr. Luke was sued by Kesha in 2014 on charges of emotional, physical, and sexual assault. In June 2023, the two reached an undisclosed deal after Dr. Luke refuted the allegations. Perry's choice to collaborate with him on her feminist-themed hits Lifetimes and Woman's World angered many. On July 12, Perry released the song Woman's World along with a music video, the whole song as well as the disorganized music video, in which Perry portrays a hypersexualized version of the World War II female icon Rosie the Riveter, were instantly attacked by fans and reviewers. An anvil and a seductive half-cyborg who rides a giant truck around town destroy Perry's Riveter. Perry revealed in a behind-the-scenes video on X that the video was satirical, but the fans were not buying it, a day after it was made public.